Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Capsule Computers Review Roundup. I'm editor Joe Morgan, and this will cover you for the week of June 30th, 2013. First, let's take a look at the big releases for the week. First, we have free-to-play MMO Neverwinter. Contributor Josh Morris and editor Joe Morgan did a cooperative review for the PC game from Perfect World and Cryptic Studios. They gave the game a great 8.5 out of 10, hailing the game for its fantastic audio design, rich world, and excellent combat, and saying that anyone looking for an MMO should consider Neverwinter. They cautioned potential players, however, that the currency system can be a bit confusing and the graphics could use a little work. Managing editor Travis Bruno published his review for the wild crossover strategy RPG Project X Zone for the Nintendo 3DS. The game from Banpresto, Monolith Soft, and Namco Bandai earned a wonderful 8.5 out of 10. He praised the game for its addictive combat, accessibility, and appeal to fans of games from Sega, Capcom, or Namco Bandai. He states that as a strategy RPG, though, it can be a bit easy and lacks the depth generally found in the genre. Wizards of the Coast released their perennial trading card game-based title this week. Contributor Andrew Day scored Magic 2014 Duels of the Planeswalkers a great 8.0 out of 10, saying that the game offers a nice tutorial, a slew of new content, and a reasonable price point, while pointing out some technical issues that detracted from the overall experience. Managing editor Travis Bruno reviewed what is arguably the highest profile game released this week with Deadpool from High Moon Studios and Activision. He gave The Merc with a Mouth a moderate 6.5 out of 10, saying that the standard action gameplay grows tiresome over the 7-hour journey, but Nolan North does a fantastic job delivering Deadpool's lines with humor. Senior editor Dustin Spencer published his review of Animal Crossing New Leaf this week. The casual 3DS game from Nintendo earned the much coveted 10 out of 10, saying it's one of the strongest games to grace the system, and in a day rampant with DLC, it stands alone as a complete package. Now for the other reviews this week. Contributor Matt Bella reviewed Samurai Showdown 2 for the iPhone this week. The fighter from Dotemu and SNK Playmore earned a solid score with a 7.5 out of 10. Senior editor Dustin Spencer published his review of Siegecraft TD from Crescent Moon Games and Blowfish Studios. The iOS tower defense game pulled a respectable 7 out of 10. Editor Simon Wolf's review of Storm came out this week. He gave the puzzle game from IndiePub and Namco Bandai a respectable score with a 7 out of 10. Senior editor Zach Elowar reviewed the point-and-click adventure Runaway, a road adventure for iOS platforms. The title from Pendulo Studios and Bulky Pix took away a middling 6.5 out of 10. Contributor Matthew Vella reviewed Garfield's Wild Ride from Microids and Namco Bandai. The iOS and Android Endless Runner scored a rough 5.5 out of 10. Bulky Pix and Heyday Games' new title Smooth Operators got its review from editor Kane Bugeja. The simulation strategy game earned a great score with an 8 out of 10. Senior editor Luke Halliday's review for Crescent Moon Games' Greedy Dwarf made it to the site this week. It earned a fantastic score with a 9 out of 10. Contributor Andrew Day reviewed Disney Mobile's game Where's My Mickey this week. The puzzle game earned an admirable 8 out of 10. Contributor Ali Nejad's review of iIllusion's puzzle platformer Elemental earned a colossal score with a 9.5 out of 10. Finally, my review of IndiePub and Namco Bandai's Capsized came out this week. The puzzle platformer was awarded high praise with an 8.5 out of 10. That's been your Capsule Computers Review Roundup for the week of June 30th, 2013. If you like this week's music, be sure to check out Rock OW at freemusicarchive.org/music/RockOW. I'm Capsule Computers editor Joe Morgan. Go forth and game.